Hi there, my name's Alexander, and I'm the technical trainer from Deep Trekker. In this video, I want to tell you about a tunnel inspection I performed recently using a Revolution ROV equipped with the Blueprint Subsea Oculus M3000D multi-beam imaging sonar. Now that's a mouthful, but really what it means is I had an underwater robot equipped with a sonar device that let me see despite the fact that the water was so turbid that the camera was essentially useless. Now, a multi-beam imaging sonar is so called because hundreds of individual beams of sound are emitted simultaneously, and the feedback or the bounce back as those beams hit structures in the environment is interpreted as a real-time video. So I'm able to visualize the environment around me in a way which is so much more than what you'd imagine with traditional side scan or even a mechanical scanning sonar. Now, what's cool about the Revolution ROV is the mount for the sonar is on the camera head. So as you rotate your camera up and down, that sonar also rotates up and down. So in this image here, the camera is actually pointed straight down negative 90 degrees. So my 20 degree sonar beam is basically being spread along the wall in front of me. The nose of the ROV is up against the wall. And so we're seeing the texture of that wall as if someone was shining a bright flashlight straight down. Now in this moment, I've switched the ROV so that the sonar is pointing straight up. I'm right at the edge of that tunnel. You can see my tether and a little bit of its shadow, as well as those bubbles coming up out of the mouth of the tunnel. But we'll bring the sonar back down to 0 degrees. At that angle, we're basically getting a cross section of the walls that are around us. If I angle it up a little bit, I see the roof of the tunnel in front of me. And if I keep going up past 90 degrees, you can see I'm right at the edge of the shaft. So there's those bubbles going up the shaft coming out of the tunnel and my tether again. We'll bring that sonar back down. At this point, we would zero out the tether counter so we know exactly where we are. And we would carry on with that tunnel inspection. Now, the D in the M3000D name means it's dual frequency. So I can switch between this low range but very high frequency mode and the wider angle view, which is our low frequency mode. Normally, the Revolution is a highly portable device that you carry in two-wheeled Pelican cases, but we were set up in a van for this mission with dual monitors so we could see the sonar and the camera view separately. We had the tether reel in the back, and we were set up with a tether counter at the edge of the shaft entrance, so we could actually keep accurate measurements of exactly how far the ROV had penetrated the shaft. Here you can see a fast pass of our tunnel. So we did a couple fast and slow passes of the tunnel using different sonar frequencies for different resolutions. So our initial passes were just looking for large artifacts or obstructions. You can see here I'm basically scanning the crown of the tunnel. There's some bubbles rolling along the surface towards me, and those horizontal lines represent the regular seams in the concrete. Now, the other thing that's interesting is you could actually point that sonar slightly down and I could see the bottom of that tunnel. Unfortunately, it's covered in sediment, so this didn't give us as good an idea of the structure. So in this particular inspection, we focused on the crown, but you can see there those two lines inside the tunnel are the edges of that sediment layer. As we moved along looking at the roof of the tunnel, you could identify cracks. You can see here there's a bit of a shadow cast behind that, so it means that there's something elevated. And we found that a lot of the cracks, we actually had sort of sediment built up as water pushed its way out of the crack, and that sediment stuck to the wall of the tunnel. Another interesting application here is you can actually point the sonar straight down as we did earlier, but because I'm inside the surround structure, I'm getting a cross section of the tunnel. So that line at the very bottom that's crossing what you would expect to be a perfect circle, that's the surface of the sediment. So you could take regular sediment depth measurements as you traverse a tunnel. Here's an example of an interesting structure that I found. Tilt the sonar up and down. You'll notice I do this a lot. I'm always panning up and down, but you see there's a long shadow. Anytime you see a long shadow, it means that the object is tall. So there's something projecting downwards out of the roof of the tunnel. So I basically just maneuver the ROV around, try and get a better look from different angles. And as I get close and sort of slightly adjust the angle, I can see there's a cylindrical object. And this is a lateral pipe that's projecting into the roof of the tunnel. You can see there's a little bit of debris sticking off of the end of it. So we marked the location of that lateral. Interestingly, it was the only one we saw in this 530 meter long tunnel. Here's another interesting artifact. You'll see two instances of it. There's bubbles down the middle. That's what that dark patch is, but there's a little bit of an oval. So here is the other end of that oval. So this oval crack is apparently something you do see in pipes. And so I was able to sort of roll side to side to get a slightly better visual of its shape. We did follow those cracks along the side of the tunnel all the way through, and we marked the start and end locations, as well as looking a little bit closer with a shorter range at the very end. And you'll notice here when we zoom in that there's a little bit of spalling taking place. Every time we noticed an artifact like this, I pause for a moment, look at the range of how far away it is from the end of my sensors. I call out for chainage. The worker who was standing at the tether counter would read out the exact distance, and then we would add to it the distance of that artifact in front of the ROV. Now here's another moment in the inspection. So we'd descended down a different shaft. You can see my tether there coming out of the bottom of this shaft. And we're looking at the intersection between a shaft and a tunnel that goes all the way through it. This is something of value because this is a potential weak point in the structure. And we did notice a little bit of spalling right on that edge. So I can line my camera up and I can zoom right in. And for stuff like this, where you wanna get a good feel for what it is and how big it is, we can actually use our sonar logs in post. Or in real time, while you're viewing the sonar on a laptop, you can use this basically the same tools in the software. You can switch through different color palettes, and you can use your ruler tool to take measurements at a resolution of 1 centimeter. So it's a pretty accurate measurement that you can do in post or in real time. Now, when we popped out the other end of one of these tunnels, we ended up in a large reservoir basin. So this is basically collecting water so that we don't have excessive outflow. And there's a number of sump pumps. There's 3 sump pumps in this image. They're off to the right. Some of those vertical structures with chunky stuff at the bottom, those are the pumps with their pipes going up. And this is the end of one of the tunnels that we had examined. You can see here, not only am I able to see sort of the general structure looking for obstructions or debris, but I can actually get a sense of the texture of the wall, try and identify any obvious cracks or breaks or crumbling. This is set to almost 10 meters of range, so you can see with our high frequency mode, we get pretty clear detail in as little as 0.5 meter or even less. So we did a little bit of a general survey, doing our best not to get tangled in any of the cables from the pumps, but using the sonar, we were able to see our way around. So I bring the sonar up to 0 degrees, so it's pointing straight ahead. So now that curved line that's curving down to the left, that's the wall of the shaft. We've got a big cross section, and these funny repeating long shadows, those are internal reflections between the pipe and the wall. When I angle the sonar down a little bit, it becomes a little more clear what we're looking at. And you can see here, we can see detail of a chain and some cables hanging down, as well as the brackets which are holding that pipe to the wall. Descend a little bit. I'm going to sort of angle that sonar up and down again. We're looking at the same pipe here with some of the same equipment, but I'm seeing how they all attach to the top of that pump. There's a chain. There's even an obvious large link there right in the center of the chain. This was not a key feature of this particular inspection, but we were interested to see that everything was in order, no obvious damage. It's a great example of how in turbid water, you really can penetrate complex environments with lots of obstructions and avoid getting tangled. The key is just to pilot very, very slowly and keep panning that sonar up and down. In this shaft, we did an outward facing orbit with the sonar pointing down, looking for artifacts in that shaft wall. So here you can see there's a bit of a crack, and above it, there's actually a pit. So we got close, zoomed right in, took some measurements of its location and its size, noted that down. Now, there's one more story that I want to tell before we close off for today. And at the start of one of the days, there was an engineer taking some LiDAR scans of the space above the water in one of the shafts. And unfortunately, his tripod broke and the LiDAR scanner fell to the bottom of the shaft. So I was able to pilot the ROV to find it, but I couldn't get a good grip on it because it didn't have any, it was a pretty smooth object and it was very, very heavy, so it would slip out of my grabber. But they lose stuff down tunnels all the time, so they had a cable grab, so this large claw on the end of two ropes, and when they pull on one rope, the claw closes around an object, and you pull on the other one, it opens. So you can see here, what I was able to do was get the ROV into a position where I could see the LiDAR device, and then guide the position of the rope from the surface so that they could grab onto that structure. They did manage to catch it and then they dropped it, and so it landed sort of pointing up, leaning against the wall. So in this image, my sonar is actually pointing up and this is it leaning against the shaft wall, and you can see they managed to get a hold on it, and then I followed it all the way up to the surface. So multi-beam imaging sonar is an indispensable tool, and not just for navigation and searching, but it can be utilized to conduct detailed inspection and evaluation of underwater structures in absolute zero visibility environments.